Joe Chille began his radio career as an announcer at WJJL Niagara Falls in May of 1970. In 1973, he was hired by none other than fellow Hall of Famer Kevin O'Connell at WYSLAM, a job that lasted all of 3 months. Joe moved on to WGRQ-FM, using the moniker Shadow Stevens for an 8-month tenure that Joe described as the best job in radio at the time. He moved over to WYSL-FM for a 5-month job before heading back to WJJL in the Falls as program director from 1975 to 78. In August of 1978, Joe became operations manager for McCormick Communications' beautiful music, WBNY. In 79, the station switched to soft rock WJYE, Joy.
The new 96.1 Joy FM.
When you think of the total person, I mean, Joe was totally dedicated to the radio station, totally dedicated to programming a great radio station, also being a talent, doing mornings for how many years, also being involved in the community, doing a lot of benefits as we all, you know, make an effort to do, having a great radio station and sounding great in the air day in and day out for as many years certainly is fitting for him to be inducted into the Buffalo Broadcasters Hall of Fame.
So after a series of jobs lasting as little as 3 months, Joe stayed on for the next 34 years and 1 month, through many ownership changes, overseeing a format change, and managing a staff of programmers, producers, and engineers, while directing all the on-air content and serving as morning host for 25 of those years.
Joe Chille was my very first mentor in broadcasting. And he was wonderful to take someone who really had very little formal background in broadcasting. He really kind of had to do from, you know, soup to nuts on on-air presentation and delivery and timing and all those things that they say you really can't teach someone, which in a way you can't. But Joe really had a great way of developing talent. And I know I'm not the only one who's benefited from that. But more than anything, he was so generous with his time. And having worked with, you know, several co-hosts and co-anchors over the years, I've really come to appreciate his willingness to be supportive and to guide and to encourage and let the co-hosts sometimes be the star, which I thought speaks really volumes about Joe's character. When I think of Joe Chille, I think of the words pure professional. I think of someone who works to the highest level every day. Joe showed up at 5 a.m. with his A game and gave 110%. He is so worthy of this honor for his longevity, certainly as well. You can't survive that many management changes, that many format changes, to be not only the talent, but to also be a program director and to be a mentor to so many in a station for all of those years really speaks to really what is the wonder of Joe Chille, a pure professional who has lasted in this broadcast industry, in this town that I know loves, that loves him. He's really one in a million.
Fellow Hall of Famer Vic Baker has described Joe Chille as the gold standard for radio broadcasting in Buffalo. He took to the airwaves with grace, class, and a consistent smoothness that is a rare commodity in today's industry.
There are places I remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone and some remain. All these places have their moments with lovers and friends. I still can recall some are dead and some are living.
In recognition of his dedication, longevity, and personification of all the qualities that make a top professional broadcaster, we are proud to induct Joe Chille into the Buffalo Broadcasters Association Hall of Fame class of 2015.
In my life, I love you more.
It's not goodbye, it's till we meet again. and I'm sure we'll see you somewhere along the way. God bless you all. Thanks for making my life so happy.